On to your health headlines, a recent increase in measles and mumps cases in the U.S. has health experts stressing the importance once again of getting vaccinated. Dr. Mitchell Goldman with UCSD is here now, as he is every Tuesday, Dr. G, to talk more about this. Thanks for being here.
Great to be here, Kathleen.
All right, so here we are again. We have an outbreak. What do you attribute this to? Is it people not vaccinating their children?
Yes, it is. Now, measles is probably the most contagious disease around. And if someone has measles and you're in a room 100 feet away, you're going to get measles as well. So that's why it's so important. It's also important because measles is a deadly disease and can actually cause brain damage in people. So about 99% of all of us get vaccinated. But what happens is that 1% of people that do not get it vaccinated makes it more risky for those that cannot be vaccinated, or because of maybe they're too old or they're too young.
Well, Dr. G, there is this ongoing debate you and I have discussed several times on the show about whether vaccinations are safe. First of all, in your view, are they? And secondly, are they all created equal? Or if people can skip one to make themselves feel better, should they? Or what do you recommend here?
Well, in the last 10 years, the Centers for Disease Control has done 9 separate large studies, all proving that all vaccines are safe. They have totally discredited the one study that was then thrown out of the journal for bringing this alarm. But still, people say things, and some of the people just don't say the truth. And so vaccinations are safe. Every physician knows this. Every person knows it, and 99% of us do vaccinations. The second question is, can we do something to make it safer? Well, we can delay vaccinations instead of getting all of them at once, spread them out a little bit. But that's usually only for younger children. I vaccinated all my children on schedule. And so there's no real reason to be concerned about vaccinations as long as you're doing it with your pediatrician.
And there's a real active debate here because parents who are getting their kids vaccinated are seeing their kids in danger, so to speak, of some of these diseases that were long put to bed because vaccinations were working.
Yes, it's like measles. You know, measles was basically, there were no measles cases in the United States, but measles is a worldwide problem. And it just takes one person on an airplane coming from somewhere to start it again. Polio is another one. We haven't had polio in the United States for over 10 years, but polio is endemic in certain parts of India. And it just takes one polio person to come over to spread the disease again. So that's why it's very important to be vaccinated. But it's not just the childhood diseases. Things like shingles, herpes zoster, which can cause a very painful neuralgia and a very ugly and scarring rash, can also be prevented. And so one needs to get vaccinated starting at age 50, for sure by age 60, so you don't get shingles. So there are other things that we always talk about around flu season, the pneumonia vaccine, hepatitis vaccines. Right now, there's a big outbreak of mumps in Hawaii, especially in colleges, because so that these preventable diseases really can be prevented just by getting vaccinated.
All right, Dr. G with the last word. Thank you.
Good to be here.